Why would you use the profitability index method in capital budgeting when other tools like return on investment and net present value already exist? To answer that question, let's see what return on investment, ROI, and net present value, NPV, provide us. ROI relates the payoff, the expected project benefits, to the investment, the initial cash outlay or cost. NPV considers the time value of money and considers cash flows over the entire life of the project. The profitability index incorporates all three of these elements. The profitability index is closely related to ROI and NPV. Once you understand how to calculate ROI and NPV, it is very easy to calculate the profitability index next. Here's a project that we will use as the basis for all calculations. It has an upfront investment of $1,000, shown as a negative, an outflow, and 4 years of nominal benefits of $400 each, shown as positives, inflows. To calculate ROI, we take the annual benefits and divide them by the investment. $400 divided by $1,000 is 40%. Now that we have calculated that ROI outcome, is this a good or a bad number? You can look at this in absolute terms. Maybe the company that is considering this project has a minimum requirement of 30% ROI for projects, and the ROI on project A exceeds that minimum. You could also look at this in relative terms. Maybe there are many other project proposals with ROIs that are 50% or higher. In that case, project A might not be the most attractive one, and other projects might get higher priority. To calculate NPV, you start off with translating the future benefits to today's equivalent. These are called present values. The present value of $400 1 year from now, using a discount rate of 20%, is $333. $400 divided by 1.2. The present value of $400 2 years from now is $278. $400 divided by 1.2 times 1.2. The present value of $400 3 years from now is $231. $400 divided by 1.2 times 1.2 times 1.2. The present value of $400 4 years from now is $193. $400 divided by 1.2 times 1.2 times 1.2 times 1.2. The longer we have to wait for those future benefits, the more we have to discount the future benefits, the lower the present value equivalent. To calculate NPV, we take the cash outflow, negative number, from the investment and sum the present values of the future benefits. Those five numbers summed, the investment plus the present values, get us to $35 of net present value. Now that we have calculated the NPV outcome, is this a good or a bad number? You can look at this in absolute terms. NPVs that are bigger than zero create value for the company. You could also look at this in relative terms. Maybe there are many other project proposals with NPVs far higher than 35. In that case, project A might not be the most attractive, especially when the investment budget is tight and not every project with a positive NPV might up getting selected. There is one important number from the NPV calculation that we will need as an input for the calculation of the profitability index: the sum of the present values of the future benefits. In the case of project A, this is $1,035. Let's calculate the profitability index for project A. Put the sum of the present values of the future benefits in the numerator and divide by the amount of the initial investment in the denominator. Working with present value equivalents is how the profitability index resembles the NPV method. Dividing by the amount of the initial investment is how the profitability index resembles the ROI method. $1,035 divided by $1,000 gives us a profitability index of 1.035. Now that we have calculated that profitability index outcome, is this a good or a bad number? You can look at this in absolute terms. Projects with a profitability index higher than 1 create value for the company. You could also look at this in relative terms. Maybe there are many other project proposals with the profitability index far higher than 1.035. In that case, project A might not be the most attractive, especially when the investment budget is tight, and not every project with the profitability index higher than 1 might end up getting selected. There are several ways to write down the profitability index formula. You could express it as the sum of the present values of the future benefits divided by the amount of the investment. You could also express it as the sum of NPV plus investment divided by the investment, or as NPV divided by investment plus 1. When you plug in the numbers from our profitability index example, you see that these versions of the profitability index formula are all equivalent. $1,035 divided by $1,000 is 1.035. The sum of $35 and $1,000 is $1,035. Divide this by $1,000 and you get 1.035. $35 divided by $1,000 is 0.035. Add 1 to this and you get 1.035. Different ways of writing the profitability index formula, same outcome.